So we're in really exciting times. Never before have we seen so many Indigenous students entering Ontario universities. At the same time, however, we're not seeing the retention of Indigenous students at the same level as non-Indigenous students. We don't see as many Indigenous students graduating, and we don't see as many Indigenous students moving on to postgraduate work, to medical school, nursing school, and other professional degrees. Ontario's Indigenous Mentorship Network hosted a number of Indigenous undergraduate students at a workshop in February 2018 to talk about some of these issues, to talk about what inspires Indigenous students to come to university in the first place, about people and places and moments that have inspired them, and about how they find sense of belonging. The purpose of this video is to share what we heard about their educational journeys.
In my second year, I took a Sexing the Nation course, which is a women's studies course at Laurentian. And at the end of the term, we had to write this big term paper. And so I wrote my little butt off and I was really proud of it and I handed it in. And when I got it back, because I always love getting my feedback from my professors, and my professor had written on the back of my paper, "This was by far the best paper in the course, and have you ever considered majoring in women's studies?" And so in university, like, feedback like that was few and far between from my first year, because I had gone from a science classroom on my First Nations community with four people in it to a class of like 300 people in my intro to psych class. So having that gratification that, hey, I'm Indigenous and I am smart in the eyes of a non-Native person really just spoke to me, and that was kind of the turning point for me to say, like, I'm not smart for a Native person, I'm smart as a person.
It was this academic advisor, and he's actually, I believe he's South Asian, so he's Indigenous to somewhere, but he's not Indigenous here. You always want your role models to be like Indigenous, right, so that they know what you're going through. So I think on his part, he had a huge amount of empathy and understanding of my situation and where I was coming from. So essentially, we had this really candid conversation when I first went in to go see him for the very first time. He said, you know, there's a lot of people, he said, where they honestly don't belong in university for various reasons, right? It's just different learning style. They might be more suited towards a trade or college or anything like that. He said, I firmly believe, he said, you belong here. He said, you belong here. Your learning style, your capability, he said, everything that you want to do in life, you belong here. And that was probably the biggest life-changing moment that made me realize that, oh, I actually belong here.
A lot of times when I feel like I can't do my PhD or I get stressed out, this one moment comes to mind, and it was when last year I was giving a presentation to my nation, because I'm really interested in the metabolic diseases in First Nations communities, and that's kind of where my research is. So I asked if I could do a presentation at one of our general meetings, and I was standing up there in front of everybody and the room was silent. Everyone was looking at me and I was talking and they were listening and they were learning from me, and it just was so inspiring to me. And everyone like thanked me after the presentation, and they thought, wow, like, this is so great that you're going to school and you're learning. And then our newly elected chief, she had like was kind of fighting for our nation to become leaders and fighting for us to be a good nation, and she said, we just had this wonderful young woman give us a presentation who will probably go on to do her PhD. And at the time when I gave the presentation, I was only in my master's, and then that was the first time I thought, whoa, maybe I actually will do a PhD.
My first year that I came here, I took introductory to First Nations. I really tried to take my Indigenous knowledge that I'm learning from my First Nations studies and apply it to my other like non-Indigenous courses.
So a few years ago, when I was working as a mental health worker here in this community, in the Indigenous community, I had an opportunity to meet with a physician. He was presenting at a conference, and he was sharing his story about, you know, his journey working in addictions and mental health as a physician downtown east side of Vancouver. A lot of Indigenous people, lots of trauma. And as he was sharing his stories and his insights and the teachings that he had picked up along the way, I recognized that as he was speaking, a lot of his teachings, these are the same things that I've heard elders and traditional healers talk about over and over for this is where they work, this is where they operate. And I remember looking in the audience left and right, and I see all of these doctors, nurses, social workers, other healthcare providers, and they're literally on the edge of their seat saying, I've never thought about it this way before. This is so innovative. I have to incorporate this into my practice. And so I'm sitting there thinking to myself, all of this stuff is old hat. This isn't new knowledge to me. What's the difference between that doctor at the front of the room and all of the medicine people that I've worked with? It's like, oh yeah, that's right. He's got an MD. He's got a piece of paper that validates his knowledge, his words, I should say, in our society. So I knew at that moment that if I was going to make that difference and see that change that I wanted to see and be that change that I wanted to see, I had to come back.
I feel like there was a lot of issues in my young adulthood and my teenage years where I kind of denied myself that Indigenous identity. I didn't want to be associated with it because it carried so much racism with it and it carried so much stereotypes with it. When I started going to First Nations House, when I started going to community events, and I started really, the biggest thing, to be honest, was finding a sense of community in the cultural support on campus. So going to elder circles, going to gatherings, and going to ceremony. And I realized how connected and how important that is. And having a connection to your identity is basically what kind of gets you through life and what gets you through challenges.
I acknowledge that I'm a white passing person, and I could probably find that sense of belonging in sort of that mainstream space. And the reasons that I self-identify are because I want to share that knowledge, and I want to work to empower and uplift fellow Indigenous students who are going down this path.
The hardest thing for me in finding a sense of belonging is I have to walk two lives. I have to walk the life of science and research, and then I identify as a very spiritual person. And I found, especially this year, is that I've let the spiritual side go, and I focused too much on belonging to a science, belonging as a science student, as someone in scientific research. And it's actually been very detrimental, I think, to my health. And I didn't really realize it until this weekend, and I got to reconnect with that spiritual side. And I think that's my sense of belonging, is I need to remember I belong in both worlds and I belong in both walks.
Finding that sense of belonging isn't necessarily attached to a place, but for sure it's attached to a feeling. You know, I acknowledge that for me and my journey as a first year medical student coming in, I'm a few months into the program, into the second semester of the program, and I'm very different from a lot of my peers in that program. Many are coming from places where they've really excelled in the sciences, and it's great, it's a beautiful way to understand the world. But I acknowledge that there's far more to that. There's a lot of conversations around embodied learning and land-based teachings and all of those things, and for me those are really important. Finding that place of belonging in the institution, it's very difficult, particularly when you're studying something like allopathic medicine, where its roots are in hierarchy. Its roots are in we are the experts and everyone else is not the expert. Finding belonging in that is hard because that's not inherently our way.
Everyone in my community who believes that I can do this is what motivates me to do it, and I think in the direction that I'm going that there is no room for failure, because failure is suicide. And in clinical psych, failure is addiction, failure is abuse, and failure is anxiety, and failure is low self-esteem, and failure is continuing to allow Indigenous knowledge to be something othered and not recognized or valid in institutions. So my motivation is I refuse to fail for my community, and I refuse to fail for Indigenous people in Canada.